हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, चैप्टर सरफेस एरियाज़ एंड वॉल्यूम्स एक्सरसाइज 13.6 ऑफ क्लास 9, क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 ऑफ एनसीईआरटी बुक एक्सरसाइज 13.6। द इनर डायमीटर ऑफ अ सिलिंड्रिकल वुडन पाइप इज 24 सेंटीमीटर एंड इट्स आउटर डायमीटर इज 28 सेंटीमीटर। द लेंथ ऑफ द पाइप इज 35 सेंटीमीटर। फाइंड द मास ऑफ द पाइप इफ 1 सेंटीमीटर क्यूब ऑफ वुड हैज़ अ मास ऑफ 0.6 ग्राम। सो लेट understand with the help of a figure. See, suppose this is a cylindrical wooden pipe. So why? Because it has given us that inner diameter as well as outer diameter. Wooden pipe is 20, diameter is given. It means this one is the inner one and this one is the complete is the outer one. Yes, so inner diameter, let represent by small d, that is given by 24 centimeter. It means radius will be 12 centimeter, 24/2, and the outer diameter is this complete diameter from this vertex to this vertex. This is the outer one, and this one from the red. That's why I have used the two colors of red. Red I have shown, and this material, that is here it is hollow. Yes, and it is made up of wood. That's why it is called a wooden cylindrical pipe. Now capital D is equal to 28 centimeter. It means capital R means the radius of the outer diameter is equal to 14 centimeter, so that we can easily write 28/2, that is equal to 14 centimeter. Now we can write here inner radius is equal to 12 centimeter. Yes, and the outer radius is equal to 14 centimeter. Now, and its outer is 28 and the length of the pipe means is 35 centimeter. This is length of the pipe is 35 centimeter, or we can say the height is equal to 35 centimeter. The length of the pipe is, find the mass of the pipe. If the 1 centimeter cube of wood has a mass of 0.6 gram. So this is the thing that we will do after this. First of all, we need to find out the mass of the pipe, means the volume of the wood, the capacity. Yes, so volume of the wood in the cylindrical pipe, that first of all we need to find out this. So first of all, we have to remember formula for volume of cylinder. That is equal to pi r square h. Yes, this is the formula for volume of the cylinder. Now see, we need to find out only this material. Yes, the wooden one. So what we can say, how we can find this radius? See, capital R, this one from this point to this one, minus this one. Yes, from this point to this point, this center to this vertex, this is the outer minus inner, we can get the radius of this. Yes, so volume of wood is equal to pi r square minus r square, that into h. Clear? Now pi, the value is 22/7, into r, that is the 14 square, minus small r, that is the 12 centimeter, into h, that is 35 centimeter. Yes, 7 into 7, 7 5 is 35. So we have directly got 22 into 5 I have taken, and 14 square is equal to 196 minus 12, that is 144. That is the easiest one. But if the number is large, so we can use the identity also, that is a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. that makes our calculation sometimes easy. So we, first of all, we know that ki how much time we are taking to in solving the calculation, in solving the question, how calculation should be easy for us. So since we know that already, we know that the square of 14 is 196 and the square of the 12 is 144, so that we have written directly. Suppose the number is large and you don't remember square, so what you can do, simply use the identity, that is a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. That makes your calculation easy. Now 22 into 5 into, that is 52, that will equal to, after calculating we can get this one 5720, yes, centimeter cube. Yes. Now what we have to see, according to the question, they need in a gram. Yes, they need in a gram. If 1 centimeter cube of wood has a mass of 0.6 gram, 1 centimeter cube is equal to 0.6 gram. So instead of centimeter cube, we will write 0.6 gram. So 5720 in grams is equal to, multiplied by 0.6 gram, and that is equal to 3432 gram. Now this is the gram that we have find out. If we want to convert this gram into the kg, we simply, because 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg, so if we divide this number by 1000, we can get this mass into the in kg. 2/1000 kg, that is equal to 3.432 kg. yes, I hope it is clear. Yes, simply the main thing that we have to remember here, because we need to find out the mass of this wood, so we have to find out this radius. We need to find out the radius for this from the outer radius minus the inner radius. Yes, and after that we need to simply put the formula, that is pi r square h is the volume of the cylinder, and after solving this, since it is already given, 1 centimeter cube is equal to 0.6 gram, they want in the grams, so we have put 0.6 gram instead of centimeter cube. After calculating, we have found out in the gram, as well as if we want to convert into the kg, this is the answer in the kg. Okay, now proceed to the next question. That is also a very interesting question and my favorite one also. Now this is the question number 6 of exercise 13.6, the chapter surface areas and the volumes. This is from the NCERT, question number 6. Yes, a lead pencil consists of a cylinder of wood with a solid cylinder of graphite filled in the interior. So as we know that pencil is the from the point that we write is made up of graphite. So a lead is a cylinder, of course it is a cylindrical shape. The diameter of the pencil is 7 mm and the diameter of the graphite is 1 mm. This is beta 1 mm. Yes, if the length of the pencil is 14 centimeter, find the volume of the wood and that of the graphite. So first of all, let's draw a figure for this. Now this is the, again to make you clear, now this portion, that red portion, is of graphite. Yes, and the diameter is given, the diameter of the pencil is 7 mm and the diameter of the graphite, is equal to 1 mm. Yes, and diameter of the pencil is 7 mm. Yes, now 1 mm is equal to 1/10 cm. Since the height is given in the 14 cm, height we will also write 14 cm. it is of cylindrical shape. Now what we need to find out, we need to find out the volume of the wood, first of all wood, and that of the graphite. And the graphite ka separately we need to find out. Separately for the wood, this red dots denotes the graphite and this black dot denotes the wood. Okay. Now, first of all, we will convert this into the centimeters. So the capital D is equal to 7 upon 10 centimeter. Yes. And capital R is equal to 7 upon 20 centimeter divided by 2. Same. Small d means the diameter of the graphite is 1 upon 10 centimeter and the radius is equal to 1 upon 20 centimeter. Yes. Now, first of all, since they want the volume of wood as well as volume of the graphite, first of all we will find the volume of wood, because it is quite easy for us. How? Because for this radius, just outer radius minus inner radius will get this, the radius for the wood. As the volume of cylinder, is equal to pi r square h. Yes, this is the formula. Now, volume of wood, that will equal to pi capital R square minus small r square into h. So pi is 22 upon 7 and see capital R is 7 upon 20 minus small r, that is 1 upon 20 into h, that is 40. Yes, 7 into 7, 7, 2s are 40. 22, 2s are 44. Into 7, 7s are 49 upon 400 minus 1 upon 400. That is equal to 44 into 48 upon 400. Yes. And 400s are, that is equal to 11, and 11 into 48. So 11 into 48, 11 8s are 88, and 11 4s are 44 plus 8, that is equal to 52 upon 100, that is equal to 5.28 centimeter cube. Clear? Now we have find out the volume of wood, that is equal to 500 5.28 centimeter cube. Now we need to find out the volume of graphite. See how we can find out the volume of graphite. If we can simply find out this directly using the volume, that is the small r, either this, that you have to find out pi r square h, r will be 1 upon 20. Yes. And the second thing is also that you can do that, find out the volume of pencil and wood. Already you have find out from volume of pencil, you can subtract volume of wood and you can get the volume of graphite. Yes. So first of all, I will tell you the that we will find out volume of pencil, so that it will be easy to find out how we can find out the volume of pencil. Yes. And when we subtract this, we can get the when we subtract this volume of pencil minus volume of wood, we can find out volume of graphite. Total mein se hum agar ye wala subtract kar denge, we can get this. Or वी सिंपली अलोन फाइंड आउट वॉल्यूम ऑफ ग्रेफाइट. सो वी विल यूज बोथ द मैथड. नाउ वॉल्यूम ऑफ पेंसिल, सपोज द क्वेश्चन कम, यू नीड टू फाइंड आउट. इंस्टेड ऑफ क्वेश्चन कि वॉल्यूम ऑफ ग्रेफाइट, इट इज आस्क्ड वॉल्यूम ऑफ पेंसिल. सो हाउ वी कैन फाइंड आउट वॉल्यूम ऑफ पेंसिल इज पाए आर, कैपिटल आर वी विल यूज हियर, वॉल्यूम ऑफ कंप्लीट पेंसिल, सो कैपिटल आर वी विल यूज हियर, दैट इज 7/20. सो आर स्क्वायर एच दैट इज इक्वल टू 22/7, कैपिटल आर दैट इज 7/20 स्क्वायर इंटू एच दैट इज 14. 7 × 2 = 14, दैट इज इक्वल टू 22 × 2 × 7 = 49/400. Yes, so that is equal to 44 × 49/400, 111, that is equal to 11 × 49. Yes, so that is equal to 11 × 9 = 99, and 11 × 4 = 44 + 9, that is equal to 539/100 cm³, that is equal to 5.39 cm³. Now from that, how we can find out the volume of graphite, that is equal to volume of pencil minus volume of wood, that is equal to 5.39 − 5.28, that is equal to 9 − 8, that is 0.11 cm³. So this is the volume of graphite. Now since we need to find out the volume of graphite, here we have find out volume of graphite, but this is the long method. Yes, but why I have used this method? Suppose they question us sometimes, you need to find out volume of pencil also. Yes, so how you can find out? Then the third thing, volume of graphite. So in that case, you need to find out only the volume of pencil, and the wood already you have find out, and for the graphite you can simply subtract. Let's try to find out volume of graphite alone. Yes, so see, first of all, don't be confused. Here we have already find out volume of wood. Now directly just leave that, how we can you can get to know how we can find out volume of pencil. Now I am telling you how alone you can find out volume of graphite. Graphite is here only, so just let's try to find out volume of graphite. So volume of graphite, this is another method. Yes, that is equal to pi r square h, and 22/7 × 1/20² × 14, again 7 × 2 = 14, that is equal to 44. Yes, 44 × 1/400. Yes, and 11/100, so that is equal to 0.11 cm³. Quite easy. So this is how we can find out volume of graphite. This is very easy. Yes, according to the question, what you have to do, because they in the question find the volume of wood and that of the graphite, yes, volume of graphite we have find out, volume of wood, sorry, we have find out by pi r square minus rs, because wood is the that black dots. So to find this radius, we have to subtract this radius. We have to subtract the gray, capital R means the outer radius minus the inner radius. Yes, so we can get for the wood. So we have calculated here for the wood, that is 5.28, and for the volume of graphite, that is the red dot, we simply use the inner radius that we have find out here. Yes, but I told you, if you need to find out the volume of pencil, so how you can find out the volume of that? At that time you have to calculate that, you need to use the capital R. Yes, so I hope it is clear. And this type of question where the cylinder is not completely hollow and you need to find out the mass or the wood and the metal, whatever. Yes, so how you can find out when the outer diameter or the outer radius as well as inner radius is given to you? So I hope it is very clear to you, and that is the thing that I want to tell you for the class 9, that is important also. Yes, so sometimes you will never get the direct question. Yes, so thank you students.